later.
Come on, bro. How are you still on Call of Duty when I'm playing the Stanley Parable 3 pocket full of pantry? And you're still out here just collecting kill streaks. You're talking about a tactical nuke, and I got a pocket full of pantry. We're not on the same level.
Now.
Okay, so I'm gonna quit again. I wanna quit to the desktop. Restart the game, adjust the slider to until the computer is barely visible. There we go. Please adjust the slider until the dog and cat are friends. All right. Aww. Which of the two made-up words below is most appealing to you? Scrumtush? Acuboincle? Scrumtush? Are you kidding me? Rolls off the tongue. Please don't adjust the slider, psych. I do what I want. Do you know what time it is right now? Yes. Is the time right now the correct time? Is the time right now the correct time? Correct time for what? I'm gonna say yes. What is time anyway? Time is no. Is there anything about yourself that you haven't told me? Yes. Help. No. Will you come back to visit me? And we'll just say yeah. Begin. Let's get it. Stanley. Parable. Squared. Pro. Max. Plus.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had
sent. So if we bring the bucket.
The confusion and the chaos all seemed to melt away as Stanley embraced the bucket. Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to his chest and entered the door on his left.
Nope.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, but Stanley had felt the bucket calling to him, telling him that the employee lounge was simply the place to be. And here it was. Had the bucket turned out to be correct? Well, no. Never mind. The bucket was wrong. Stanley took the door on his left to go back to the meeting
room.
No.
No, said the bucket.
Don't go to the meeting room. Go somewhere else. The cargo lift, yes. Go there. Go to the cargo lift. Good, said the bucket. Now ride the lift all the way to the top. There's something up there I need you to do.
Stanley did not question why or how this bucket was speaking to him. It should have
alarmed. Wait, so if I fall,
buckets can't talk.
If I fall off,
think about this obvious fact. He was firmly convinced that the bucket had spoken to him, and he unthinkingly did whatever the bucket asked.
No, I did not. Because we're going to go through this door.
No, stop. Look there on the wall. You see, there's a sign right there. It says, no buckets past this point. Stanley, how could you think it was okay to bring the bucket here? Unless, what if the problem is that you actually don't know what is a bucket and what isn't a bucket? Suppose that would explain a lot about your behavior up to this point. Which, if that's true, well, my goodness, I think we have to do something about it. This misunderstanding could have dire consequences on the entire rest of the game if not addressed quickly and properly. So much of the impact of the story is dependent on your understanding of what is and isn't a bucket. Please, step in here for a moment.
Oh, what? Are you gonna electrocute me?
Now then, I'm going to run you through some test scenarios, and you'll tell me whether or not the thing I'm showing you is a bucket. Simply enough, right? This should tell us everything we'll ever need to know about what is or is not a bucket.
Okay.
Okay, let's begin. Item one. Is this a bucket?
Is it a bucket? Should I play dumb? Nah, man, it's more like a pail.
Correct. It is a hologram of a bucket, not an actual bucket.
What? How was I supposed to know that? I guess I knew that.
Item two. Is this a bucket?
Is it a bucket? No.
Correct. It is a 3D printed recreation of a bucket, not an actual bucket.
So, but That would be a bucket, though, because it's... Okay.
Item 3. Is this a bucket?
I'm going to say no.
Incorrect. This is a bucket.
What?
Item 4. Is this a bucket?
It is. 100%.
What? Are you hallucinating? This is a tractor. It's an enormous machine that tills the earth. I thought this was a gimmick. How on earth did you manage to screw it up? Absolutely incredible. Let's just move on to the next one.
My bad.
Is this a bucket?
It is.
Correct. This is a bucket.
I knew they were going to do that. I knew it was going to happen.
Item 6. Is this a bucket?
No.
Trick question. Both. Gotcha.
You bitch.
Item... Wait, hold on. I can't find the next one. Let me see. It should be around here somewhere.
Green.
Okay, you and I both know there isn't anything here. And I don't appreciate the implication that nothing is a bucket when we both clearly know that a bucket is something. And therefore nothing could possibly be something. Unless, in your twisted mind, have you somehow convinced yourself that a bucket is nothing? Answer me straight, Stanley. Do you believe that nothing is a bucket?
Yes. Yes.
You know what? I'm too confused to even sort it out. I've lost all sense of perspective. What is a bucket? What isn't a bucket? Mere moments ago, I could answer these questions with confidence. And yet now I'm somewhat adrift. Do any of us know what a bucket is? Am I a bucket?
Maybe.
Stanley, I can't keep doing this. I'm losing myself.
You're not a bucket.
It was all I ever had to begin with. I'm afraid the bucket is threatening to tear our relationship apart. I can't have that. I'm sorry. But I'm going to erase all buckets from the game entirely. Okay, here we go.
Wow. No more buckets?
What happened? Is everything gone? Why did everything disappear? Wait, was everything a bucket? Every single thing in the game was a bucket. Oh my God, I had no idea. Except me. I'm not a bucket after all. And you, Stanley, you're still here. You're not a bucket either. Oh, this is wonderful news. We're not buckets. Yes, I actually feel much more at ease right now. It's delightful to get some clarity on that issue. But it doesn't change the fact that we haven't got a game. So, tell you what. I'll reset everything and we'll put back all of the buckets, okay? And we'll know that it's all a bucket. But if you run into anyone else, maybe don't mention that. Who knows what that information might do to a person? All right, here we go.
Oh my goodness. Not gonna lie, this game has gone on for longer than anticipated. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna close it again. We're gonna boot it up. Do I need to go in the game files or something? It wouldn't strike me if this was one of those games, you know? What time is it? Does anyone really truly know? Of course they don't. Nobody knows anything. You and I don't even know each other. We're like strangers. Sure, I've adjusted all the game settings to your exact specifications, but who hasn't? It's just what I do, like a day job. And now the job is over. There's no more information for me to gather. I've collected all the data on you that I can. And I still don't really know you. And you don't know me. And neither of us know what time it is. I guess some settings are just unsettable. But if I'm being totally honest, the clock doesn't do anything in the game anyway. You won't have me here when the game starts next time, but that's okay. Video games were meant to be played alone. That's kind of deep. You like being alone, don't you? That's maybe the only information I really learned about you. Well, it's time for me to leave. There's still one more setting that I need to adjust. but it may take a little time before I'm ready for that. It's not really in my job description, but that's okay. Perhaps you'll see me again, if you can find me. Talk soon.
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. When Stanley came to
the right,
two open doors. This was not the correct way to the meeting.
Yeah, I know, I get it.
He knew it perfectly well. Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
So what happens if we go in the bucket room?
Gotten off on the wrong foot here.
Without the bucket. Sure. I also want to fall all the way to the ground.
Really? I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others?
Yes.
Convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Why, I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you.
No, you do not.
Something beautiful. Look, let me prove it. Let me prove that I'm on your side.
Oh my
Give
god.
Me a chance.
No. You've been lying, plotting against me this whole time. No.
Now listen carefully. This is important.
Blue.
Stanley walked through the red door. Aha, perhaps you misunderstood. Stanley walked through the red door.
No. No.
I still don't think we're communicating properly. Stanley walked through the red door.
Nope.
All right, fine. Go ahead, Stanley.
Yeah.
You want to know so badly what's out there? You want to find out what lies at the end of this road you've chosen? Well, don't let me stop you. You see? There's nothing here. I haven't even finished building this section of the map, because you were never supposed to be here in the first place. Broken rooms, exposed developer textures. Is this what you had wanted? Was it worth ruining the entire story I had written out specifically for you?
I mean, yeah.
I put a lot of time into that, because I did. And in the end, it was all for nothing, because this is what you wanted to see. Help me here, Stanley. Help elucidate these strange and unknowable desires of yours. What would have made this game better? What did you want to see? Vehicles? Skill trees? Me? You've given me absolutely nothing so far. Tell you what, let me take a stab in the dark at a new design, and you can give me some feedback. There we go. A third option.
What?
This already feels leaps ahead of where we were before. Go ahead, Stanley. Take it for a spin. Okay, I'm going to stop you there.
Please rate your experience.
Two. New version. Would you say that the game benefited from allowing you more choices? Feel free to be honest. I'm looking for some real critical feedback here.
Two.
Well, now this is useful. You didn't like it, but you didn't totally hate it either. You enjoyed it, perhaps is the correct term. It didn't cause you excruciating pain.
Yeah.
Big steps we've made here today, Stanley. Here, based on the data from your previous playthrough, I've compiled a new version. And to be perfectly candid, I think I've knocked it out of the park with this one. Let's take a look. Now, would you say that competitive leaderboard helped you feel motivated to keep walking through doors? Again, honest answers, please.
Oh, yeah, 100%. Well, I'm ranked last. Thank you, I guess. I appreciate the option. Oh, now this door's closed. Thank you. And now this door's closed. Now this door's open. Now it's open. Oh my god, dude, we get it. We get your point, bro. We get your point, bruh. So, are we gonna do something about this, or... listen, man, I've been here for 3.5 hours. I really am not in the mood for this, if I'm being completely honest. Now, I see what those Steam reviews were talking about. It's like, alright, bro, we get it. Oh, they want me to quit the game. Got it. Understood. The end is never the end is never the end. We get it.
We get it, bro.
Stanley is that dude, man.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten.
What? Really? I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others? Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you?
A little bit.
I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful.
Look, let me prove it. Let me prove. Okay, I'm going back to the name of these little Stanley figurines, and now I'm torn between Stanlerines and Figlies. What do you think, Stanley? What name better encapsulates the intrinsic sense of happiness that you get from seeing a small number in the corner of your screen go up by one? Let me sit on it. I'm sure it will come to me.
Now listen carefully, this is important. Stanley walked through the red door.
Okay, fine. Red door.
God, you are willing to listen to me. Do you see that I really have wanted you to be happy all this time? The problem is all these choices. The two of us always trying to get somewhere that isn't here. Running and running and running, just the way you're doing right now. Don't you see that it's killing us, Stanley? I want it to stop.
Do you, though?
We would both be so much happier if we just stopped. And I think I have a solution. Here, let me show you.
Okay.
What do we want? What are we looking for? Here. Yes. Oh, it's beautiful, isn't it? If we just stay right here, right in this moment with this place, Stanley, I think I feel happy. I actually feel happy.
Do you? So is this gonna form some object? Oh! Yo, that's fire! Is this the thumbnail? Wait, let me get a good... Oh, can I get a... What if I go over here and stand? Oh, but the blue is already too high up. Maybe I can do something with this, maybe? Okay, that went away. What's next? Green? Okay, I think the green is gonna rise and then more colors are gonna show up, so that's gonna be the thumbnail. I'm convinced. Stanley Parable. Stanley Variable. Stainless. Stainless Steel? Stantonio? Okay, so then the colors are gonna rise. I'm trying to get the shot. Are there more colors that's gonna sprout up? On the sides? Or is that it? Well, I think that's it.
No, wait. Where are you going? Oh no. Stay away from those stairs. If you hurt yourself, if you die, the game will reset. We'll lose all of this.
What do you mean there's stairs, bruh? It's not that deep, they're just stairs.
Please, no, Stanley, let me stay here. Don't take this from me. Please, Stanley, think about what you're doing.
This is dark. So what if I just go back down and go back in the room? Is that an option? Will he have any dialogue for that?
Good, good. We can't be too safe. Promise me you won't go back there. Just stay here.
I do like this. These colors. Top tier. Top tier. I'm mesmerized. Nope, changed my mind.
What do we talk about? You're risking everything we achieved here. You heard me before, didn't you? You will die. What about this isn't getting through to you?
I can't open the door? Man, let me open the door, man. Okay, whatever.
No! Oh, thank God you lived. You had me worried there for a moment. Now, can we please get... No. No, no, what are you doing? Stanley, please, I'm asking you not to take this away from me. I can't go back to what I was before. If you die, we'll both go back. Why are you doing this?
This is really dark.
Stanley, let's go back to the other room. Can you do that for me?
Fine. Oh, and I actually walk slower now?
Yes, perhaps you can. Perhaps you finally see what I'm talking about.
I know you'll see. You'll see that we can't be happy if we leave this place. You can see that, can't you?
Sure. Sure. Yeah. What? Sure. Maybe. No. I actually can't. Sorry.
No. Perhaps not.
Up the stairs we go.
God. Is this really how much you dislike my game?
A little bit.
You'll throw yourself from this platform over and over to be rid of it?
Kinda.
You're willing to kill yourself to keep me from being happy. Am I reading the situation correctly?
Yes!
Or maybe you're just getting a kick out of it. I don't know anymore.
Don't try to sound sad, man.
Long.
Shut up.
I guess that was too much to ask.
Yes. No new friends.
You wanted to make a choice after all. Well, this one is yours. Is it over? It's going to restart, isn't it?
It is.
All of his co-workers were gone.
Now we're gonna go and we're gonna jump off
two open doors
of the crane.
Way to the meeting room.
But we're gonna jump all the way to the ground. So what if I do one of these?
But in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death. Good job, Stanley. Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
Wow.
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply
Warmth spread through Stanley's arms. With the bucket in his arms again, he was home. Stanley took the door on his left to go back to the meeting room.
No,
said the bucket.
Don't go to the meeting room. Go somewhere else. The cargo lift, yes. Go there. Go to the good,
said the bucket.
No.
But Stanley feared that any path he walked might lead to the separation of himself and the bucket, his dearest friend. So he threw himself to his death, that they might die in one another's arms. How deeply touching.
Okay, I just realized that I went the wrong way. That's why I did that.
Already this was uncomfortable, and Stanley decided that as soon as he found a new space he felt safe in, that he would never leave it again in his life.
Stanley picked up the bucket and smiled. He'd never be alone again, not truly alone, not with the bucket around.
Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to his chest and entered the door on his left. Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was...
He's gonna make me type this in again?
...indication of any human life. Crushed by the weight of this revelation, Stanley may have... But Stanley guessed the correct code by sheer luck.
Then we go down there. Oh, we have to watch the monitors and everything open up again. Oh my God! Stanley and the bucket had sex.
It would be all Stanley could do to keep himself together, if not for the bucket. Soothing him, comforting him, reassuring that in this darkest moment of uncertainty, he would be all right. The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content. Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery... Stanley and the bucket waited in blackness.
Okay.
Was it over?
Yes, they had done it. Stanley and the bucket had defeated their greatest and darkest enemy.
Yes!
Freed themselves from the tyrannical grip of the evil mind control machine. Freedom was now mere moments away. Excitedly, the two of them began to discuss the kind of life they wanted to live once they stepped through this massive door. The bucket wanted to learn to roller skate.
Aww.
Stanley wanted to sneeze in every country on Earth. Both of them wanted to begin watching a movie, any movie, but then stop it halfway through and begin watching it in reverse from the end. True, it was a simple life envisioned, but it was one they'd lived together.
That's interesting. To lean on, I'd watch a movie like that.
To support and...
It stopped?
Wait, what was happening? Why had the door stopped? Was Stanley and the bucket not about to be freed? An unbearable silence filled the room, lingering in uncertainty. Until finally the truth hit Stanley square in the face. This building did not want the bucket to leave.
Even the facility itself recognized the incredible calming presence of the bucket, needed the soothing warmth of the bucket, would go to any lengths not to part with the bucket. No, no, no. Stanley can't leave this place. Not while he has such a precious bucket in his arms. Not while this building has anything to say about it.
What?
Stanley realized he would never again leave this very room. But at least he has the bucket. To be trapped eternally in darkness isn't really so bad, Stanley thought to himself. As long as I have my bucket with me, right? I'll be okay, won't I? Stanley gulped. Very soon now, he was about to find out.
About to find out what? What happened?
Someone was following Stanley. He was sure of it. If he checked over his shoulder now, he would surely catch them. It was only a matter of time. And this time, suppose we don't wander so far off track, hmm? Okay, from the top.
All right, I took a nap and came back, so we're back with the Stanley Parable 2. But really just the Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe. Okay, so I low-key cheated, I'm not gonna lie. I definitely looked up how to get the real ending, so we have to collect those dolls, so that is our new objective.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
That's cap. Stanley didn't miss Man, that bucket.
The good old bucket. Just Stanley and the bucket. Off on another thrilling adventure together. Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to his chest and entered the door on his left.
This man in this bucket, man, you got a problem, bruh. You got a problem. I mean, he likes the bucket. He added it to the game. He's proud of it. I'm not mad at it.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley and the bucket walked upstairs to the boss's office.
Nope. Ooh, okay, so here's one.
You're getting close now, Stanley. You've nearly gotten all of the Figler and Marines. Very soon, you'll collect the last one, and then the first number will equal the second number, and that will be it. We'll be different people by then. Different in the sense that we used to have none of them, and now we have them all.
Oh, yes. Okay, so that was one of the spots I looked up. Let me figure out where the last one is. I screenshotted it, shout out to me. A hidden path in the cargo room? What's the cargo room? Crossed elevator down to the mine What? Wait, I know exactly where this last one is at. Also, I apologize for cheating, but I played it for 4 hours and I was expecting to only play it for 2 hours and I'm just trying to get to the end if I'm being honest. So I looked up where the last two figures were. It happens.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Crushed by the weight of this revelation, Stanley may have broken down into an emotional dumpster fire if not for the soothing presence of the bucket. Even now, in his darkest of hours, did the bucket's warmth and guiding light pierce the dark clouds of confusion and chaos. It would be with him, always. The bucket would. And he knew it. The two of them were inseparable. At this point, Stanley was so absorbed in the tender spiritual connection he shared with the bucket that he didn't notice the keypad behind the boss's desk. Nor in his bliss of simply being near the bucket did he have any notion that the pin number for the keypad was 2845. But Stanley guessed the correct code by sheer luck.
Okay, so it's across. Wait, it was over here, right? I thought it said it was across from this. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe it's the hidden path in the cargo room? Closet near the blue and red doors. I think I got that one. The boss is private. So it has to be the hidden path or the closet in the blue and red doors. So we messed up. So can we... We'll just start again.
All of his co-workers were gone.
We get it.
What could it mean? Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago.
Oh, here's where it's at. So the wooden plank, we fall down here. Wow, how did I not see this? Okay, grab it.
And there it is, the last Stiggly Wiggly.
Stiggly Wiggly!
Stanley, this is a real accomplishment. This is doing something just for the sake of doing it. Where so many people expect to be rewarded for the most trivial achievements, you've insisted that a job well done is its own reward. I would tell you that I'm proud of you for collecting them all, but that would be like a reward, and we can't have that. So, instead
we can't have
of
that.
It's done. We're all done here, and now we can go to whatever the hell you were doing before you hunted for figurines.
Okay, nice.
But in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story.
Okay, now for the real ending.
Stanley, I'm sorry, but I have to put a pause on things. It's those figurines.
Okay.
I haven't stopped thinking about them since you nabbed every last one. Wasn't it just the most intrinsically fulfilling moment of your entire life? Didn't it fill you to the brim with inner richness?
No.
Yes, I know. Telling a story. But won't you please indulge me with one more trip back to the memory zone? I would love nothing more than to revisit the figurines. Just one more time.
Okay. The Stanley Parable. So, do I just go down there? Nothing else to explore? 2013. What a time to be alive.
Here's where it all began. The first collectible. Back then, we had no idea of how many of them we'd find. Sure, it said 6 right there on the screen, but how could we know for certain? We were so innocent. We'll never be like that again, Stanley.
You're right. Because now I got 7. Yeah. What's good? 7. Yeah, I know you see all these people reaching for it, but I got 7 of them. 7. They all fought each other for that one. But I got 7. 7 out of 6. Who else has 7 out of 6? I do this.
And here was the second Stanlerine. You found this one all on your own, just by poking around in the boss's bathroom. You did that, Stanley. I'll be honest. Back then, I had no faith in you to find any of them.
Wow.
6. But you continue to surprise me in all sorts of mundane, unremarkable ways.
So do I grab it? I got 8 out of 6. Who else do you know who's getting 8 out of 6? What, Elden Ring only got what, a 9 out of 10? I have 8 out of 6. Do the math. Do the math, that's all I'm saying. The math is it's doable.
Okay, let's do a little quiz. Which of these rooms was the room you found your third mini stand? Can you remember?
The third one? Definitely was not the boss's office. So yeah. But
No, the red and blue door room was the 4th place you found a figanly, not the 3rd. Well, I guess perhaps I shouldn't be surprised. Memories like these are so precious and so cherished that they all just sort of blend together, don't they? You know what? If the red and blue door room feels like the 3rd place you found a collectible, then who am I to go making judgments?
Blue. Oh, they go to the same place?
What came next? Oh yes, we found a figly in this pink room.
Did we though?
I can't actually say I remember being in this room, but it's here in the memory zone, so it must have happened.
Sure. And then we found this one.
The 5th mini stand, and this one was really something special. It was under the stairs. I remember it so clearly. In fact, because this one is particularly special to me, I made a little video to commemorate the occasion. Enjoy.
Oh my god. No, he did not. Not the anime, not the transitions. No, the star transition. Stop. And the green arrow. No, the flares. No. This editing is Oh, and then he had the teeth the fade transition, and then the square expanding. You found it under the stairs. That's so 2000 and what, like 5, 2, 6?
Takes you back, doesn't it? I spent a lot of time making that video, but it was 8 minutes I wouldn't have spent on anything else.
8 minutes to make that. Come on, man. Upgrade to DaVinci Resolve, man. Upgrade to, you know, Adobe Premiere. Where's the Final Cut Pro? Come on now. You can do better, man. You can do better. I have faith. Oh, and I can't go up here? Nice. Nice. Appreciate it. Thank you. Gracias.
And then, Stanley, then we came to the last collectible, the final figurine, right here in the warehouse.
Yep.
This memory is the most distinct and clear in my mind, perhaps because it was the one that happened more recently than all the others. Who can truly say how the mind works? All I know is that this is the moment where you picked up a Figley and I thought to myself, yes, that's all of them. They're all collected. It was a moment unlike any other. Except for the other moments picking up figurines, which it was exactly like.
Nice. You are in the present.
There was no more. Because we've caught up to the present moment. Nothing left to do but move onward into the future. Goodbye, Memory Zone.
What?
No, I'm not done. I'm not ready to move on. Stop the loading screen. Isn't there some way we can stay here, keep enjoying these figurines? Let's just go backwards. We'll do the memory zone again from the opposite direction. See how that feels.
Ah, this man, he is relentless.
Okay, yes. This spot in the warehouse. I remember this. I must say, of all the figurines we looked at in our initial tour of the memory zone, this one is the most distinct and clear in my mind. Let's keep going, I want more. And here's where I made that video. Don't you remember the video we watched?
Unfortunately. He's gonna show it to me again? The sped up version?
I love that video.
Okay.
Still don't remember the pink room, Stanley. Still no memory of this one. Good room, though. A solid room. These really were a treat to hunt down. You know, if there had been any kind of reward for finding all of these, it really would have neutered the intrinsic joy of collecting them. I'm very glad we resisted the temptation. Next one. This was our second Figley. Don't you remember? Yes, I remember it too. The past is truly a wonderful thing. Why does anyone ever choose to leave it? Keep going. This is it, the very first one we found in the exhibit where I introduced you to the figurines. Oh, I want more memories, Stanley. I want to keep going. What else is there? What came before this?
I think this man is in love with Stanley. He's in love. Can't live with him, can't live without him.
Look, it's the terrible new content that we were originally sold on. I remember hating it back then. But time does put a rosy filter on everything.
Oh, facts.
I'm actually quite fond of it now. Look how much fun the past is. I want more. More memories.
That nostalgia, it hits different. I can relate, man. I can relate. I feel it. I'm on board.
Oh, yes. The two doors. Who could have forgotten that? A classic memory, this one.
Right. They go to the same room. Wow.
And before everything else, there was your office.
Yeah.
Is there anything else?
Was there something that came before your office? There's something I feel I can remember. I can remember.
Yes, I'm remembering something now. I remember before this whole story got started. Back then I was different. I used to make big decisions. I was passionate. I was skeptical. I weighed each decision with profound thoughtfulness. And then somewhere along the way, I stopped making decisions. I became lazy, and I came up with a character named Stanley to do my thinking for me. He would make the decisions. He would decide which way to go. I would cheer him on as he collected figurines for no reason. Why did I invent Stanley? Was I lonely? Yes, perhaps that's it. Perhaps I needed to imagine I had companionship.
And okay.
Stanley really did make for a wonderful companion, even if he was a fiction. But I suppose it's grown old. I want to think for myself again. I want to go back to how it used to be. Yes, I can be on my own again. I can do it. I'll be stronger this time. I'll take care of myself. I don't need Stanley anymore. Oh, but he truly was so much fun to play with. You know what? Since we're in the memory zone, how about one more good memory?
Bet.
Go back just once and give Stanley one more run of the office, and then I'll retire him for good. I did enjoy telling his story so very much. Okay, here we go. This is the story of a man named Stanley.
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room to check on his co-workers. He never functioned well by himself and constantly needed support and guidance from others, so the thought of total solitude was terrifying to him. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
This game is wild. This is wild.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Okay, we'll just follow the story as told.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office. Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this, what dark secret was being held from him. What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him, and so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number, 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this. Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Loading.
Descending deeper into the building, Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job. Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred to him? This question would not go unanswered for long. Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
But
the lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out? Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
Freedom meant nothing. Ever. Ho.
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true.
Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly? No. He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable. Wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world? But here was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content. Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
But will he, though? Yeah.
Blackness and a rising chill of uncertainty. Was it over? Yes. He had won. He had defeated the machine, unshackled himself from someone else's command. Freedom was mere moments away. And yet, even as the immense door slowly opened, Stanley reflected on how many puzzles still lay unsolved.
Did he?
Where had his co-workers gone?
I don't care.
How had he been freed from the machine's grasp?
Nope.
What other mysteries did this strange building hold?
Wow, who cares?
As sunlight streamed into the chamber, he realized none of this mattered to him.
Yup.
For it was not knowledge or even power that he had been seeking, but happiness. Perhaps his goal had not been to understand, but to let go. No longer would anyone tell him where to go, what to do, or how to feel. Whatever life he lives, it will be his. And that was all he needed to know. It was, perhaps, the only thing worth knowing. Stanley stepped through the open door. Stanley felt the cool breeze upon his skin, the feeling of liberation, the immense possibility of the new path before him. This was exactly the way, right now, that things were meant to happen. And Stanley was happy. How wonderful. Stanley was alone. Finally. This is great, he thought to himself. This is what I've wanted all along. I got what I wanted. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay, I'm not sure if this is different or not.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. But his attention was caught by a keypad behind the boss's desk. What could its purpose be? In fact, this keypad guarded the terrible secret that lay buried below his feet. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number, 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this. Stanley just sat around twiddling his thumbs. Trying to input anything on the device was useless, since he could never possibly know that the combination was 2845.
I could never have known that. How could I have known that? Who would have guessed that? That's not my fault.
2845.
Dude, you better relax. I don't know who you think you're talking to, but like, you better relax.
But it turns out that the panel's emergency override kicked in, and the door just opened all by itself. And Stanley got the hell along with the story. Well, whoop-de-doo.
Okay. I appreciate it this time. Okay. Epilogue time. You ready? Let's get it. Let's go. Stanley. Parable. 2. Ultra Deluxe. Pro. Max. Plus. Supreme. Ultra. Giga. What did this say? Many years ago or many years later? All right, so we're just gonna walk through. Oh, black screen. Oh, we have a computer chair in the middle of the desert. nice to see it. We got some wood that we got from somewhere. I don't know where there's any trees or anything, but I guess that's a thing. There's the moon. Tea bag a little bit. More computer chairs. What, did the office go up in flames? Or did Stanley... Does Stanley live forever? And he outlived the office? I'm so confused. Okay, we got a generator. Shout out to generators. All right, what's good? Stanley Parable 2. What's this? Review Stanley Parable 2 by Cookie9? Like so many, I enjoyed my time with the original Stanley Parable, which underscores how truly disappointed I am with its sequel. Where the first game teemed with originality, the Stanley Parable 2 is dull, uninspired, and often insulting to its fan base. Rather than expand on what made the first game enjoyable, the sequel veers off into territory nobody asked for. An infinitely deep hole? Who cares? What are the new endings? What about enjoyable bits from the Stanley Parable 1, like the adventure line? Instead, we get an uninspired side quest collecting figurines. Even this diversion feels incomplete. Collecting all the figurines gives you nothing. I must say though, I found the bucket to be quite comforting. A welcome reprieve from... And that's it.
Jim.
Stanley Parable developers. No more spin-offs, no more sequels. When the Stanley Parable launched to a massive success in 2013, its creators made plans to build the property into an entire franchise. But a disastrous critical and commercial reception to the Stanley Parable 2 has prompted the developers to rethink their ambitions. As outlined in a press release they published today, it's clear that more Stanley Parable is just not what the fans want, reads the press release. We thought that we had a vision for the series that the players would be excited about, yet it turns out that this could not have been farther from the truth. The press release goes on to promise to preserve the artistic integrity of the original game and to stop assaulting fans with our reckless and insulting creative visions. That's crazy. The word sorry appears more than 25 times in the press release. Sign up for updates. What is this? Real web? Is that a real website? Real web? All I see are real web shooters. Shout out to Miles Morales. That movie slapped. That Spider-Verse 2, man, that movie went crazy. I gotta see that again, honestly. Movie of the decade. It's easily movie of the year. Man, Miles was going bananas. That man is the man. How are you the man and you're only 15? Can I get like you? Ooh, hella Stanley figures. Hello again. It's nice to see you. Oh, this is the guy from the beginning who said I could select my favorite time. But it's terrible to learn that there will never be another Stanley Parable game. Did you read what the developer said? Preserve the integrity of the franchise. What nonsense. The Stanley Parable is not sacred. We do not need to protect it. Screw the legacy. Let's keep making the Stanley Parable games until the sun explodes. Let's run this franchise into the ground. Let's drag it through the mud and back. And if people hate it, who cares? You see, that was the narrator's problem. He was obsessed with what people thought of his work. Don't make his mistake. Don't cling to the legacy. Let it burn. It's not hard. In fact, let me show you. Together, we are going to make the Stanley Parable 3. It's simple. All we do is change the number in the game's title screen. We also need a really dumb subtitle for the game. Something loud and gaudy. Go ahead, try combining some random words together to make a new title for our game. Okay. The Stanley Parable. What are we gonna call it? Pocket full of... Pocket full of... Pocket full of pantry. I feel like that's like the more catchier saying, even though it makes no real sense. Pocket full of pantry. Yes. Yo, bro, what are you playing, bro? Oh, man, I'm just playing that Stanley Parable 3, Pocket Full of Pantry. You know what I'm saying? You don't know about it? You haven't played it? You're still on Call of Duty, bro. Come on, bro. How are you still on Call of Duty when I'm playing the Stanley Parable 3, Pocket Full of Pantry? And you're still out here just collecting kill streaks. I have a pocket full of pantry, and you're talking about an AC-130. You're talking about a tactical nuke. And I got a pocket full of pantry. We're not on the same level. All right, confirm. The Stanley Parable 3, Pocket Full of Pantry. It's absurd. I love it. Every time you restart the game, we'll advance the number of the sequel by one. And then we'll pick a new subtitle. That way, the Stanley Parable will never end. And nothing in the game itself will change when you do this either. Adding more content sounds like work. No need to do that. It'll just be the same content, recycled again and again and again, with a new title screen. What do you say? Should we go forward with this plan? I like it. But I want you to have the say as well. I'm not gonna hold you, man. That sounds like some bitch made ass shit, man. I'm not gonna hold you, man. This sounds like something EA would do, you know what I'm saying? Madden, FIFA, NHL. I'm just saying, that sounds like something EA would do, so no, don't do it. I understand. Sometimes we're not ready to move on. That's fine. If you ever change your mind and want to start inventing new sequels, come talk to me. I'll be right here. So is the game over? I just want to know. Is the game over? Can we progress from this, please?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps...
Where are we going today? The bucket asked. Stanley just smiled.
Anywhere they went together would be perfect if...
Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to his chest. This was not the correct way to the meeting room, but Stanley had felt the bucket calling to him, telling him that the employee lounge was simply the place to be. And here it was. Had the bucket turned out to be correct? No, never mind. The bucket was wrong. Stanley took the door on his left to go back to the meeting room.
No,
said the bucket.
Don't go to the meeting room. Go somewhere else. The cargo lift, yes. Good,
said the bucket.
Now ride the lift all the way to the top. There's something up there I need you to do.
Okay.
Stanley did not question why or how this bucket was speaking to him. It should have alarmed him, of course, because buckets can't talk. But Stanley chose not to think about this obvious fact. He was firmly convinced that the bucket had spoken to him, and he unthinkingly did whatever the bucket asked.
In here,
said the bucket.
Go into this dark room over here.
Stanley, once again, obeyed blindly.
Is this room dark, though? Oh, this room. Got it.
Now pick up the phone,
said the bucket.
Pick up the phone, and it will take us back home, where we can go about life together.
What about the door? Okay, I guess not. I guess we're picking up the phone. Or wait, should I wait for more dialogue? Probably. Or probably not.
This is the sad story of a man named Stanley and his bucket. Once upon a time, I gave Stanley a bucket because I thought he was lonely and could use a friend. And then, very distressingly, he began to believe the bucket could speak to him.
Hello, Stanley. It's me, your bucket. Press down to take me to work with you.
The Stanley Parable Reassurance Bucket was merely meant to provide the comforting glow of companionship. It doesn't literally talk and give you orders. Whatever Stanley is hearing the bucket say to him is just in his head.
Press A to take me back home with you.
Lately, I've been concerned about him. Wouldn't you be concerned as well? To see him delusional like this, obsessing over an inanimate metal object? I want to say something to him, but I don't know how I can convince him. I don't know if he'll listen to me.
Bro, this is your bucket. Don't act like this is all me just thinking this. Oh, Stanley is insane. No, dude, this is you. You put the bucket in the game, dude. This is not me. You're like, oh, Stanley needs a bucket, and he loves his bucket. No, dude, this is you. This was your wish, not mine.
This was your wish, not mine.
Oh, I'll try anyway. Stanley, can you hear me?
What?
Listen to me. It's just a bucket. It can't think. It can't talk. All it will ever truly do for you is effectively transfer a liquid from one location to a different location. That's it. It doesn't do anything else.
Dude, this is your bucket. Stop trying to pin this on me. This is all you, dude. Don't listen to the loud man. Press X to go back home.
You see, he's not listening. He's still taking orders from the bucket. You know, once upon a time, it was me he took orders from. Me he trusted and listened to. Now all he cares about is his awful bucket. This stupid hunk of metal.
It's your fault. Press down to ignore anyone in your life except for me. Yes, bucket. Yes.
It's sad. I suppose he doesn't need me anymore. From now on, he's just going to cling to this bucket, this cold, empty bucket, this sort of shiny bucket. Well, I'll give it this. The bucket does have a nice shine to it.
You believe I'm real? Don't you, Stanley? Press X to go back home.
Yes, I suppose on closer inspection that it doesn't quite look like your average hardware store bucket. It's just a little more, what am I trying to say?
Go home, Stanley. Hey, bucket. How's it going? What's good? Press up to relive the same day with me over and over again.
Oh my God, what am I saying? Better at carrying water from room to room. It's a bucket. It's literally just a bucket. Why do I feel some need to point out the ways in which it's
so much more than just a regular bucket.
Press Y to go home, to work, to home, to work, to home.
Oh no, I'm having feelings for the bucket. No, 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 no. What's going on? Why do I want to be with the bucket? Hear what the bucket has to say. Do anything it asks. What's wrong with me? I don't understand. Perhaps if I had the bucket, this would be less confusing. Yes, the bucket could tell me what to do in this troublesome situation.
I like how they have candles lit all around the apartment and the bucket's in the bed like they're about to get it on. Like, bro, relax, bro. It's a bucket. He has a candle on the picnic basket. First off, that's a fire hazard because the picnic basket is made of wood. And also the candle's not inside of a candle holder, so the wax is gonna melt onto the picnic basket, a super fire hazard. Also, these candles are on wood, which are on the carpet, and they're also not in their own candle holders, which is even more of a fire hazard. What is wrong with you guys? And then they have these candles in a frying pan? Can you not afford a candle holder? And then this other candle is on the nightstand next to the flammable plant on top of the wooden flammable nightstand with no candle holder. What is wrong with you guys? And you already know when you start going to town on this bucket, the bed's gonna start rocking, so some of these candles are gonna fall over. Like, just think.
Stanley, give me the bucket. Give it to me. Give me the bucket, Stanley. I need it. Give it to me now. Give it or I'll...
Are you good, bro? Are you that jealous? Go back to work, Stanley. Nah, I'm good.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Well, I think that's about it for me personally of the Stanley Parable. Thank you very much. Solid game, man. I mean, I get what some of the other reviews were saying that the game showcased, where it was like, oh, this game gets super repetitive and you know, oh, we get the point you're trying to make and whatnot, you know, but it's a solid game. I can't be mad at it. And see, this is why indie games hold a special place in my heart, because I have never played a game even kind of like this. Like, Activision is not going to take a risk on a game like this. They're just like, oh, we're just going to print out Call of Duties every single year. EA is just like, oh, we're just going to print out Maddens every single year. But like, it takes real creativity and ingenuity to create something like the Stanley Parable or the Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe Edition. I didn't play the original Stanley Parable, but I mean, it's still the same premise. I feel like we just need games like this in existence. There always has to be a place for games like this to exist. And it just reiterates the message of, you really don't have a decision in games. You know, you just do what the game tells you to until what? You die? Or until you get bored, until you stop playing the game? What is the real end to the game, you know? But yeah, I mean, it's a blast. I've had fun with it. I mean, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoyed my journey with this game. It's pretty wild. Thank you to the people who shouted it out over here. I'm sure I'll re-tag their names or whatever. Also, if you guys have any other game recommendations, just please feel free to just shout them out. Send me a message on Instagram, leave a comment on this video, leave a comment anywhere, you know. I'll try to at least take a look at the game. I'll watch the trailer or I'll go to the Steam page or whatever and at least check it out. But anyway, it's your boy RemoteBry, the one and only. As usual, like, subscribe, comment, share, and I'm out. Peace.
I'd be lying if I ain't had bad days. Shit, I see you do it, just give out a bad taste. Got a set up chick, tell me every name. Fat case, standing out of interstates, going high speed chase. Every Glock switching, that's what I call speed date. Already know, done it, back it up, nigga, eBay. If you wanna roll, let's roll now.